every node. So of course heapification will trivially exit if the node already represents a subtree that's a heap. But if the heap property is violated at that node, then heapification will fix it. Now the claim is that this particular procedure is going to run in order n. It's not going to run in order log n, because as we saw, heapification in itself, a single heapification operation is going to run in order log n time, where n is the number of elements rooted in this subtree. So a loose upper bound on the complexity of this build heap algorithm that I just described is order n log n, because heapification takes log n time, and we'll be in the worst case running heapification on n elements, so it's going to be n log n. But actually it turns out that that's a very loose bound. We can actually show that the real bound is order n. How do we do that? Notice that if you know something about binary trees, you know that nearly half of the elements of a binary tree are rooted, are placed in the last level. Right? Let's take a complete binary tree which is filled all the way up to level h. So level 0, level 1, level 2. Let's assume that this tree is rooted, filled, completely filled up to level h. So it's a complete binary tree. How many elements are there on level h? 2 to the power h, right, in the last row. How many elements are there in the remaining part of the tree? 2 to the power 0 plus 2 to the power 1 plus 2 to the power 2, and so on, till 2 to the power h minus 1. And this sum, as we saw, is just 2 to the power h minus 1. So basically, half of the elements in the whole tree are present in the last row itself. And among the remaining elements, half of them are going to be present in the penultimate row. So there is a greater concentration of elements down at the bottom than at the top. Now if you notice, when we apply heapification in this way, so let's try to formally work this out. Let's say I am at level So this is level 0, level 1, level 2, this is level h, and I'm visiting the nodes in this particular order. This is h minus 1. Now how many nodes at level h will I visit? 2 to the power h. And when I run heapification on them, each of them is going to take just order one time. Right, approximately order one time, because you know they're just nodes in themselves. So in fact I don't even need to run heapification on them. I can directly start from the internal nodes, because heapification does nothing on leaves are already heaps in themselves. So but anyway, let me just include this for argument's sake. When I run heapification on these nodes at level h minus 1, how many nodes are there in level h minus 1? 2 to the power h minus 1. Now heapification on them is going to, so let's say this took 1 unit of time. This is because, you know, it really does nothing, but you know, we'll just abstract that out and say that it was a unit operation. Now here we may need to do a single swap, right, when we run heapification on these nodes. So I'm going to call them as doing an extra unit of work. When we do heapification on these nodes, we'll be doing an extra unit of work compared to heapification here. When we do heapification on the next level, we may potentially end up doing an extra unit of work compared to heapification here, because in the worst case, we'll need to swap them two levels down. Right? So when we look at level h minus 2, we'll be doing, you can say, 3 units of work. When we look at level h minus 3, we'll be doing 4 units of work, and so on. And finally, when we come to the root, we'll be doing approximately how much? H plus 1. This is the worst case. right? So we are looking at build heap. Worst case time of build heap will be this much. So we can represent this as a series. So at the ith level, so I is 1 here in the last level, I is 2 here, I is 3 here. So basically this is I, 1, 2, 3. So I can represent this as sigma I multiplied by 2 to the power, I is getting multiplied by 2 to the power h minus I plus 1. Is that right? When I is 3, it's 2 to the power h minus 2. When I is 3, it's 2 to the power h minus, oops, it's I minus 1, sorry. H minus I plus 1. So it's basically sigma I 2 to the power h minus I plus 1. Yes. And I varying from 1 to h plus 1. So we can simplify this. We can say, well, this is 2 to the power h minus I. So we can take out 2 to the power h plus 1 from this summation because it's a constant. We have I equal to 1 to h plus 1 of I multiplied by 2 to the power minus I. This is the same as 2 to the power h plus 1 sigma I equal to 1 to h plus 1 I divided by 2 to the power I. Does anybody know the value of this sum? How do you calculate? This is an this is an AGP, an arithmetico-geometric progression, where, you know, every successive term is not just being multiplied by a ratio of half. You're also adding, you know, in the numerator is getting increased by 1. So I assume that you have, you know, some background in calculating summation of arithmetic series, geometric series, and arithmetico-geometric series. But I'll just tell you that this is actually a constant value. So it's going to be somewhere close to 1. It's going to be either half or 1/4 or some summation, because, you know, the exact value will depend on, you know, how you count things. Whether you count this as one unit of work or whether you start counting from here. But it's going to be some small number. You can calculate this. It's going to be half or 1/4 or some number like that. Let's see if we have the time at the end to calculate that, because I think we're running out of time. But this value, 2 to the power h plus 1, if you remember, is basically approximately n. Where did we do that? Here. 2 to the power h plus 1 So 2 to the power h, if there are h levels here in the tree, then the number of nodes in the tree is 2 to the power 0 plus 2 to the power 1 and so on till 2 to the power h, which is 2 to the power h plus 1 minus 1. So this 2 to the power h plus 1 is actually n plus 1. So the value of this summation is n plus 1 multiplied by some small number, some integer. And that's order n, right? So this is order n multiplied by this whole sum, which is actually a constant. Actually, the way you calculate this summation is not from 1 to h plus 1. You can calculate all the way to infinity. If I extend this summation to infinity, I'll be getting something larger than this summation, right? So in other words, yeah, Sorry, can you repeat? Yeah, I'm almost done. So I'm almost done with this build heap thing. So 2 to the power h plus 1 summation from I equal to 1 to h plus 1 of I divided by 2 to the power I is less than equal to 2 to the power h plus 1 summation of I equal to 1 to infinity I divided by 2 to the power I. Right? We are adding a bunch of extra terms. And what we are saying is let's overestimate the value of this by replacing this h plus 1 with infinity.